I would like to start my speech with a famous quote by Malcolm X. The media is the most powerful entity on earth. They have the power to make the guilty innocent and to make the innocent guilty. And that's power because they control the minds of the masses. So I agree with the fundamental assumption here. The media influence people. Media can't force us what to think, but undoubtedly they are successful to make us what to think about and which side of the coin is more important. Let me go back to the British era, when our country was ruled by the Britishers. People were suffering from their atrocities, yet no one gathered the courage to fight against them, except a few. But to spread the spark of freedom in the whole country, the Indian nationalist movement took the help of the media. It was the media who influenced people's mind to fight against the Britishers and liberate our country from them. In those days, journalism was a mission, but now it is a profession. Nowadays, it has become very easy to control the minds of the masses and make them think only about a particular thing. Let me give you an example. Iram Sharmila started an indefinite hunger strike in the year 2000 and ended it in the year 2016, that is almost 16 years. But she never got the huge coverage of media which she deserved. The matter of fact here is media do not bring the real issue before the people, nor it leaves the judgment to the people, but they impose their judgments on us and we tend to take decisions accordingly. The right way should be to listen to both the narratives, however appealing or non-appealing they are. This way, we would be able to get the perspective from both the sides and hence we can make an informed judgment. Ultimately, it is left to how much the individual is suspecting to believe everything that is fed to him by the media. Thank you.
We think too much and feel too little. More than machinery, we require humanity. Humanity, it's not just about thinking good, it's about doing good to others. Any task we do for some good is humanity, like feeling good for someone. Every person on this planet is connected to a particular culture, religion or traits. But we must not forget that it's humanity that comes above all of us and makes us better. The world in which we live is full of sufferings, but we as humans have the capacity to forget our own interests and give love and care, thereby reducing the pain and sufferings and making the world a better place to live. Humanity is not just words, thoughts or feelings for us humans, but also for the nature surrounding us, like nurturing and helping animals, taking care and plantation of trees plays a vital part of humanity. My desire for humanity is of all beings live together with love, peace, gratitude and sympathy, follow and respect the culture, traits and religion of all and give support to the needy. I truly wish the human wisdom should remove the discriminating factors and conflicts over religions and live equally as we are equal parts of God. I request all of us to start with feeding not hundreds, but just with one. My hearty wish for humanity is of all beings be good to one another and give equal importance to all, as not doing so is same as neglecting lives. I just wish each of us to come up as Sonu Sood and Mother Teresa and make this world lively. At last, I would again say that all of us has feelings, but just we need is to evoke it and make this world heavenly. I hope I was able to make you feel my wish for humanity, and I am sure we will accomplish it soon. By then, thank you.
Social media controls what and how we think. The social media actually control us. No, it doesn't, but it slightly influences us to do things that they want us to do or to trust what they want us to trust. Today we are going to talk about both pros and cons of social media. Well, during these tough times, we are at home, but we know about the happenings all over the world. How? With the help of social media. Yes, social media is a vast way through which we can communicate through the masses. Social media tells us about the happenings all over the world. Social media is so powerful that it is the fourth pillar of democracy, and social media is mostly biased with government. They either tend to support the government or tend to oppose the government. Well, As social media is also divided into two parties, that is, the one that supports and the one that opposes, whom should we trust here? Well, either we trust the reporters or either we check what's happening in our daily life. Well, just choose wisely and think wisely, because one wrong decision could lead to many regrets. As you know that social media is so powerful that it can change the innocent into guilty and change the guilty into innocent. So think wisely. Thank you.
My wish for humanity. The earth is too big and humanity is the biggest work we are doing in our life. Everyone wishes to be a good human and we can achieve this goal by doing humanity. The meaning of humanity is the work performed by humans. It is also the feeling such as love, care, sorry or sympathy that we feel for some. In science, we read that animals, plants and humans are living. And only humans have brain because God wants us to develop the world by helping, supporting and motivating each other. But if God has done equality and made us humans, so who made us Hindu, Muslim, Sikh and Christian? And is this fair? This is all done by the thoughts of people. I am not saying to end these religions. But I'm asking that why are we fighting on this? I'm not using too extreme, intense, formal or complicated words because I know that everyone here gets easy words, but not all of us can understand formal words. And if I want my speech to be wonderful and beautiful, I will definitely use formal words, and it will be attractive. But I want it to be effective, not attractive. Every sentence is my own creation, and trust me, if I can copy from internet, I can cheat with you, but not with God. That's all, and by the end, I would like to say that my wish for humanity is that if someone is in need, please help. If someone is going to do a good work, please support. And if someone needs motivation, please motivate and never fight on religion, caste, gender, race, etc. As we all are made of skin and bones and we all have heart and brain. So, we are humans and we have to do humanity. And one more thing I would like to say that we do not need nuclear power or technological advancements in the exchange of humanity. Thank you. Goodbye.
Start my speech with a great quote. That is, the best investment you have ever made is on own health. Healthy food is a requirement of our body. It does not let us feel lazy and dull. It is essential for healthy body, soul and life because health is the greatest gift. Healthy diet has lots of benefits. It keeps us healthy and fit. Moreover, it keeps away the disease like diabetes, blood pressure, cholesterol and many more. Eating a variety of food and consuming less salt, sugar, saturated and industrially produced trans fat are essential for healthy diet. Healthy diet may contain fruit, vegetable, whole grain and may include little to no processed food or sweetened beverages. Nutrition is a natural demand of every source of fat on earth. There are various types of diet that can keep an individual healthy. For example, the vegan diet, ketogenic diet, intermittent fasting. A balanced diet helps us to maintain proper body weight, keep us nourished, and our skin is free of pain and pimples. In the end, I just want to say that exercise is king, nutrition is king. Put them together. You have got a kingdom. Thank you. Stay home, stay healthy.